Let's go to Isaiah 53:5. My focus on all this is the cross. Because the cross is where forgiveness is at. Isaiah 53:5 says, "But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. And with his stripes we are healed."
Yes.
Now we all quote this scripture regularly. But I want to give us a new perspective on this. Christ said, did he not say the last, teach us a principle that the last will become first, the first will become last. On the way to the cross is what this is talking about. He didn't got to the cross yet. That's on the way to the cross. Every bit of that. He took the stripes. He was bruised, beaten, battered, cursed. Call names. The scripture ain't even dealing with the cross yet. All this right here he hasn't even got there. So those are things Christ provided before he ever went to the cross. He took the stripes before he died on the cross to give you forgiveness so that you could be healed.
Amen.
He did all those things before the cross. Then went to the cross, and the cross, when he said, it's done, it's finished. That was forgiveness. That was the moment in time forgiveness was made available for us. So the things he suffered before the cross and up to the cross now comes after the forgiveness at the cross.
That's right.
Till you accept that he died for your sins and sicknesses and infirmities, you can't receive it. Well, how do you receive it? You have to be forgiven. You have to forgive. Now, this message isn't one of condemnation or anything. This is a wake-up call. So that we will begin to examine ourselves so we can step to this next level. What church age are we today? The church of Laodicea. And what does that mean? When we study on it, we'll see. Most of the people who think they're saved are walking towards death. Do we want to be a part of that? Or do we want to be the ones that say, we fought, like Paul, the good fight of faith?
Amen.
I did everything that your word told me to do, Father. So I'm trusting at every step I take, because I'm trusting in the truth of your word. Not what the world says, not what that other preacher down there says. I know what your word says, Father. I'm trusting you to make it happen. Trust in your salvation.
Amen.
Be assured